All right. Go!
No Jovan! No Warrior now!
This park!
Microphone check, 1, 2, what is this?
No Jovan! No Warrior now!
Parks on the boards.
There's a lot of free time.
What we done with music?
I actually thought this was a good segue into
the next record. Oh, look at that.
Yo,
who else but us?
We ain't even talk about this.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not saying you're not
young Blue.
You're not getting a young daddy out of me again.
His name is
buddy.
Young Blue.
Young Blue.
Well, Young Blue put out a record with Drake.
That's daddy-ish.
Just accept it, bro. It's okay. It'd be cooler if you just admitted.
Yo, that daddy-ish is sick. Any nigga you know named Blue had all the bricks in the hood and a Beamer and jewelry.
Allegedly.
Yes. Allegedly.
Course, allegedly.
Mm-hmm. All right, Rory, get into it, man. Young Blue.
Well, Young Blue put out a remix with Drake, where Drake threw a verse on the year.
Young Daddy and Champagne Poppy collab collided world.
The Daddy collab?
Daddy and Poppy.
Look at the name of the song, though.
Your mind still?
Still.
Yeah, yeah, I feel that.
That's real shit.
Even when she moved on?
Yeah.
What does that change?
When did she move on?
No, you didn't move on.
And even if she did?
Still? Okay.
We might need a quick lyric breakdown of a part of Drake's verse, man.
He killed this verse, by the way.
Turn it down some.
Have y'all ever just went outside with Shorty for the first time in a public setting?
Mm. We spoke about this before.
And just start peeping things?
He's still on our IP.
Yeah, we spoke about this. When your girl, you go to the club with your girl and the security, all them niggas know her. And they don't know you. Like, you right behind and nobody speaks to you.
Mm. And they stop you to get in the club? And
yeah, they search
you. It's like,
you.
No, he's with me.
Yeah, they search you and they don't search her. Let her right in.
That's why you got to keep her in the car. Yeah. Yeah, I'll be right back.
Oh man, that's a real thing though.
Yeah, you stay put.
In the parking lot though. Like, you in the lot with it. You got your car in.
This is a known spot for you.
No, chill.
The dude parked your car with your girl in the passenger seat. He hops in. Chill.
Tell me, what's your name?
Nah, I'll be right back. Stay right here for 30 minutes. That's a real thing though. That just let me know, like, even when you got money, you gonna go through certain shit where it's just like,
damn. Y'all thought the game.
I'd be sitting there like, bitch, why did you bring me here? I have an ego.
Y'all thought the game was fucked up before. And John Wall finished rehabbing. Hey, y'all thought it was just hardening them. That nigga John Wall, ACL is fixed.
Yo, it's the second episode in a row. Joe has given us an injury report on John Wall.
Hey, what's up going on?
Hey,
what's
let me going on? Let me let y'all know,
he's
buddy.
He's a Wizards fan. What do you want, man?
Hey, Sammy Watkins is almost healed up. You bitches just flying to Kansas City. I bet. Oh, shit.
Oh, my God.
Le'Veon signed to Kansas City. They got four backs already. Mm-hmm. Bitches is out. Bitches is headed to Kansas City out here.
What's wrong with you, man?
Le'Veon cost me a whole fantasy season last year. Nigga want to get a deal now.
Oh, my God.
All right. Yo, y'all are idiots.
No, but this is real. I like this verse, but it's real, man. Drake is, he's
Rory, how many times has this happened to you, man? You sound triggered.
Oh, it's happened often.
Niggas hugging your bitch in front of you.
Yeah. That shit is rough. It sting a little bit. And then you gotta
They rubbing their pelvic on your bitch. You there talking about, yo, nice to meet you.
Yo. No. The worst is
Yo, what's your name again, fam?
Mind you, she didn't introduce you. You introducing yourself.
Yo, tell the nigga that hugged your girl, yo, it's nice to meet you. Yeah, you can't tell no nigga it's nice to meet you. Hug your girl, man.
You should rock, roar.
Oh, it's your section?
Rory, yo, like...
Appreciate you having me.
Rory, like, story.
You want to fucking drink?
Yo, that's your bottle?
Hey, Rory, no, that's a real thing, though.
Oh, shit.
Like, you can't go to the club with a girl and, like, she taking you, like, you walking behind her and she go to a dude's table and you standing there. Like, you can't do that.
Oh, my
Never.
God.
Oh, my God.
You can't do that.
God,
oh
no.
Oh, my God.
I'll wait over here.
And, if she don't introduce... Anytime you walking with a girl in a party or club and she not introducing you to none of the dudes, you should exit immediately.
Everybody shut up. I wasn't finished imagining different Rory scenarios. Wait, so listen. Rory there and just start whispering in her ear. Yeah, what you doing after this shit? Yo, you free after that? Fuck this nigga.
No. He said, yo, you free after this? Matter of fact, I see who you with. You definitely free. you definitely free.
Oh, shit.
That's so disrespectful, man.
Wow.
And look at what friends do when they realize a moment has triggered you.
Right.
Yeah, you got to. That's worst scenario.
That's what the homies are for.
No, it's happened to me, too. I just get right into it. So who that nigga was?
Yo, and
why you thought it was cool to have a fucking 15-minute conversation while I was ordering pineapple juice on the side?
And guess what she said?
You said you never came to New York before. Like, that's the funny part. Like, how you know a nigga in privileged?
I know. And she replied, oh, that's just killer. Yeah. That's a callback for all you comedian fans.
Oh, my God.
You had to hear me, though. Now, and why dude wrapped his arm, like, in between me and you? Like, he tried to divide.
He hugged both of y'all.
The three of y'all was kind of like...
Yeah. Fam.
Three-way
hug. Nah, you about to... I was joking on Rory, but...
I triggered you now.
Now you about to piss me off. Because when you cornered a girl in some bullshit, she act like you just made some shit up out of osmosis. Oh, no, he didn't fucking push you out the way, grab my titties, kiss me down. You didn't see it. Wait. I was standing right there. He tongued you down, my nigga. No, he did. That's just hilarious. Bobby. No,
yeah, I know.
Anytime they get off that, that's just... I've known him for like 10 years. And in my head, I'm like, so he had mad time to beat.
Yeah, he was
beating for 9 years.
Oh, see, I'm like, I'm glad you do know him because we're following him. I'm following that car to ask about that split he just did.
That is fucking funny.
Fuck out of here, man. That nigga Bobby paying for our drink.
Yo, we get so triggered by the dumbest shit.
Don't pay for my drink, nigga.
That's some funny shit.
I got $14.
Facts. Yeah, fuck out of here.
I took you to the club and you hugged on somebody that I know.
And I know those type of hugs.
Funny shit is in the strip club. You on one side of the bar going ham, throwing your little 300 in the air. Fucking CEO of some independent record label come in on the other side. She was reserving a seat for him for hours.
Yeah, you're not seeing her no more.
She heads that way. He start throwing up thousands.
Yeah.
Big Cuban.
Yeah, bust down.
Big Cuban, huh? What your little watch you got on? Big Cubans. This whole squad Cubaned up.
And they not Cuban.
Yeah. Hey, the whole squad Cubaned up. She ain't coming back to your bar in an hour with that little last cup of water you got.
Nah, it's over.
Yeah, but then the nigga look up. This has happened to me before. The nigga look up and like, appreciate you, so he starts saluting you.
Yeah.
Now you don't know if you want to be friends with the nigga or he's sunning you.
He's sunning you.
You can't go over there and start talking to the nigga.
He came to me.
Oh.
He came to me. Yo, Joe, if you need anything, we on the other side. I'm like, yo, I'm fine.
I have everything I need in life.
I have all I need, buddy.
I don't need anything.
And then point to the chick that you came here for and said, she got you if you need anything. Holy like, nah, shit. I know it too.
Yeah. Yo, and I like that bitch that you got on her knees picking up money.
It's a lot of money.
You got her on the floor. I'm just handing it to her. Nigga.
You start picking up the money with her? Like, nah, you did good tonight. You did good tonight.
What you said your artist name was? You said he got some stuff coming. I'm a see. Sleepers.
I got it. I'll give him a spin.
Yeah, I got it. All right, I'm shutting up. Yo, that was really
we
funny.
We are so triggered by dumb shit, man.
Because men are stupid more.
We are.
Yeah.
We are.
That's why women listen to this, because we're stupid.
Yeah, they laugh at us.
And we try to rationalize our stupidity.
Yeah, but that's funny though, and that's real because you definitely have been in the club before, and the girl that you was talking to or dating definitely was hugging some dudes. That's why it's just funny to hear Drake talk about shit like this. Like, fam, and to you're Joe's, Drake. You still going through shit like this?
Yeah, of course.
That's hilarious.
And to Joe's point of them coming in with all the chains dressed crazy, I asked her what the dress code was, and she said, casual, wear sweats. So now I'm real bummy, and the other dude she invite...
Looking good.
Never mind, man.
Clean.
It's a long story.
I feel you. I feel you.
We all trigger.
Yeah. But hey, good record.
Yeah, it is a good record. I'm not really familiar with Young Blue. But
he used to go by Young Daddy. So that's probably why he just changed his name.
And you got niggas fucked up if you think that. Listen, I don't want no beef, Aubrey. Chill out. But you know somebody out there is taking a girl or two from Drake. That's why when he do it to somebody else, he got to rub it in their face.
Yeah. That's happened to every man.
Remember, Takesha, that was at your house. I had her at mine, licking all down her spine.
I think he delivered that bar.
I was trying to be
you.
A friend, so I let her unwind. Drake, the nigga that's going to let her unwind.
Drake is definitely letting your bitch unwind at his crib.
He's got a wine rack in the bathroom. Yeah, she's all the way up.
I'm never letting none of mine go to the embassy.
You think you have a choice? That's hilarious.
Yeah, we don't have a choice.
That's some confidence, Joe.
Somebody posted the picture of somebody posted the old YouTube link of when I did that Drake interview outside of and at 40 I was laughing because the energies was just very different that year. It's like she was having a birthday party that I had no plans on going to until Drake said he was going if I was there. So I was going for him and he was going for her.
Holy
I'm
shit.
I'm like, nah, yeah, it's her birthday, but step outside. Let me get this. Let me get this clip right quick. Let's talk about it. And then boogied.
Oh, my Yo, God.
Listen, 09 was a crazy year.
It was.
09 was a crazy year.
Great year. So much of the disc album you put out makes sense now. You could have just summed it up with that. I get it now.
But what?
The 14 disses you put out.
We have 9,000 women in common. Like, don't try to boil
it's
it down
more,
to
it's
one.
More records
it's,
to come.
It's more than meets the eye.
Yeah, but how many birthday parties you got in common? It's a little different.
That do hit different.
Eskimo Brothers means nothing. We all have that. But Eskimo Birthday Brothers is a little different when you're in the section singing happy birthday together. Mm. It changes a bit.
I didn't stay for that. What the fuck are you talking about?
Oh, he did.
Good for him. I'm out.
He had to blow out the candles.
I was cheating by then. I'm not trying to stay here. You know those rare opportunities in a relationship when your girl gets busy and you can go be busy without a hassle? Mm. It was like one of those. I was immature. Yeah. This is toxic. Listen, we're years clear ago. On that. We're clear
you were
on
young.
That.
You were young.
Yeah, I was young.
Over
I was
10
young.
Years ago.
Maul, can you break down the Drake, Nicki Minaj, We're Friends Again post? I know you put it together. I know you was kind of like the liaison.
I didn't even see this. I have no
Maul
idea.
Maul never sees anything.
I didn't see this, yeah. She posted, Drake posted the Nicki record with Sada Baby. Okay.
And apparently there was a bar.
Playdate's coming soon. Oh, that's dope. Yeah. Because Nicki just had her child, yeah. Okay.
She had her kid?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Congratulations.
Yeah.
A boy. Congrats.
I think we congratulated Nicki when she had a baby on here.
I thought
it was a few weeks ago.
I thought we did too.
Yeah, it was a few weeks ago.
My bad.
A few weeks
I'm
ago.
Late. I thought we were congratulating.
But that's dope. I never thought that Nicki and Drake had a beef that they were never going to speak again and all of that. And they both have kids now. That's what it's about. Hope one day
there's
we do a
play date. For Drake to beef with anybody about.
Facts.
Except for maybe Kanye.
You would think. But I knew that him and Nicki weren't. I mean, I knew they would still be family. Like, it's a little tiff, but that was years ago.
Tiffed.
Yeah, they had a little tiffed. That's all that was.